Today, I'm gonna be showing you guys everything you need for your college dorm. How's it going? My name is Ashton Herndon, and if you're watching this video, I'm gonna assume that your college move-in is right around the corner. So congratulations, you're now on the same boat as this guy. And little does he know that life is about to hit him like a truck.
Wait, what?
Before coming to college, living on my own was all I would ever dream of. I would live by my own rules, have my own aesthetic house, and really just live out that college lifestyle that I always dreamed of living. I would watch endless dorm tours on YouTube of these crazy rooms that had the perfect aesthetic. So after seeing all these people living out my dream life, I knew exactly what kind of dorm I wanted. I started to pack everything that I could gather so I could be just like these college gurus. I had no idea what to expect from college. So I packed everything I owned to make my room as cool as it could possibly be. But once I actually moved into my room, I realized that living in a dorm wasn't what I expected at all. The rooms were extremely small, so I had nowhere to put my stuff. I had nothing that I actually needed. And worst of all, I had to share a room with this guy. My dorm experience became the complete opposite of what I thought it would be, and I had lost all hope in living out that perfect college life. And that's why I'm here today. I'm here to show you all the dorm essentials you need and everything to avoid so you don't end up looking like little me. So one of the biggest things I noticed when I moved in is that packing for your dorm is a lot more complex than just bringing stuff from home. You have to think of it as a whole process. So to make moving in a little bit easier, I broke everything you need into three categories. Things you'll need on move-in day, essential things you'll need day to day, and some cool stuff that you don't necessarily need, but is pretty cool to have. And in order to actually show you guys everything, I gotta go to Target and buy this stuff. So it's shopping time, baby. Let's go. Okay, so now that we have everything that we need, it's time for the most exciting part, the college move-in process. And let me just tell you that this is by far one of the most overlooked things when it comes to buying stuff for your dorm. Moving things in and out is already super stressful, so having the proper containers to store all your stuff is essential. And boy, do I have the perfect thing for you. Hold on, I'll be right back. These guys right here are absolutely amazing. Instead of having to worry about all the carts during move-in, having these containers to carry all your stuff makes everything 10 times easier. I mean, they hold a ton of stuff in them, they fit super easy in your car, and they're great to keep in your room as a little storage unit. But I know that these things are a little big, so if you're looking for something a little smaller, these IKEA bags are literally a lifesaver. I mean, they hold a ton of stuff in them, they have backpack straps, they fold, and they're only like $1 each, so you can buy a ton of them. As far as storing your clothes go, these plastic drawers are pretty much perfect. Some colleges out there might not have the cleanest place to store your clothes, so having one of these things is absolutely essential. They stack on top of one another, so they pretty much fit under any dorm bed out there. And if you put all your clothes in them before you move in, it saves you a lot of hassle carrying up all those hangers. Having all these things have helped me save so much time moving out. I mean, instead of taking 4 or 5 trips back and forth to the car, I literally got everything in and out of my dorm in 2 trips. And let me just tell you that if you live on any floor that's not the first floor, going up and down those stairs isn't very fun. So by putting all your everyday stuff into these boxes, you're gonna save yourself a ton of hassle. But in order to actually put these boxes to use, you're gonna need all your essential stuff to put in them. So when it comes to everyday items, one of the most essential things you'll need is this bad boy right here. The mattresses in the dorms are extremely uncomfortable, so by adding a little cushion to your bed, you're gonna save yourself a lot of sleepless nights. I mean, my whole first semester, I slept straight on the hard mattress, and let me just tell you, that shit ain't fun. So by putting a mattress topper on as soon as you get to college, you're gonna save yourself a ton of back pain. Along with your topper, you're gonna need a mattress pad. And I know that a mattress pad is very basic, but I had no idea what one of these things were until I had to buy one. So I'm gonna mention it. within the dorms, there have been so many people that have laid on that bed before you have. So by adding one of these things, it protects you from all those bugs and germs that are still hiding in that mattress. I mean, you have no idea what the people before you were doing in that bed. So if you're a germaphobe like me, this thing helps give you a little peace of mind so you don't have any of that nasty stuff on you. Outside of stuff on the bed, having the right electronic cords is definitely a must. Some of the outlets are gonna be in some pretty weird places, so buying a 10-foot charger might be a good idea to have. Is 10 feet a little excessive? Maybe a little bit, but you never know. Next on our list, we have a power strip. I mean, if you're anything like me and you have to have like 10 things plugged in at the same time, then a power strip is definitely a must. It has way more outlets than the one you're gonna find in the wall, so I mean, you really can't go wrong. And for our final everyday item, we have what is by far the most essential part of your bedroom. Wait here, let me get it. This guy right here will literally save your life. From my personal experience, almost every dorm that I've been into is hot as shit. But that's where this guy comes in. Having a fan is amazing because if you're like me and like to sleep in a cold room, it helps you to stay cool even when you can't control the temperature. Not only does the fan keep you cool at night, but it also produces this really peaceful white noise. So turning that fan on can help you avoid a lot of nights like this. And obviously on top of all this, you're gonna wanna pack all your other essentials. But before you even move in, my biggest piece of advice to you is to please, don't bring everything at once. And I know you're probably thinking,
oh Ashton, if I don't have something and I need it, my life will be over.
No, half the stuff you bring with you to college, you won't even touch once you unpack it. So surprisingly, you're gonna need a lot less than you think. My rule of thumb is that if you don't use it once a week, you probably won't need it. But there are some things out there that are pretty nice to have every once in a while. One thing that I like to have is a pretty nice light in my room. Hold on, let me go behind the scenes here. Pretty nice, huh? A lot of the dorms have some pretty crappy lighting in them, so having this is a huge lifesaver when it comes to filming my videos. And it changes colors too, so it can match the vibe of any situation you're in. It's some pretty cool stuff, I know. Along with a nice light, you might want to get yourself a nightlight to avoid waking up your roommates at night. I mean, those dorms can get pretty dark, so this might help you out a ton when you gotta go pee at night. The next thing is a beach towel. I know that I don't like using my bath towels when I go to the beach or the pool, so having a designated towel for those things is great for me, and it's something that most people don't even think about, so you should definitely bring one. Another essential is Downy Wrinkle Release, and if you've never heard of it before, it's pretty much like an ironing board in a bottle. I mean, regular irons take up a lot of space, and they're a little scary to use, so by using this bottle, you save yourself a ton of space and a lot of stress with it too. I would definitely bring an umbrella and a rain jacket because there's a 99% chance that it's gonna rain at least one day while you're at school. And even by just simply keeping this stuff in your room, it'll save you from a lot of rainy days like I had. And last but not least, we have the sponsor of today's video, Liquid IV. Nah, I'm just kidding. Could you imagine though? Liquid IV, if you're watching this, comment down below. Let's talk. But seriously, if you've never bought Liquid IV before, it literally cures any sickness. Whether you go out for a late night at the club, feel super sick, or even just feeling a little sluggish throughout the day, I guarantee you that this will fix it. Whenever my friends come back from a rough night, the first thing I do is just give them a Liquid IV, and I kid you not, they feel better like that. And just to put it out there, I'm not a health expert by any means, but from my personal experience, this shit works pretty damn well. So now that I've shown you all the college essentials, you're ready to move in, baby. And I know that there's a ton of other nice things out there that you might get for your room, but these are the bare minimum things that help me survive college without spending a ton of money. So as long as you stay calm and pack everything we talked about, you'll turn out a lot better than I did. So if you guys found this video helpful, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. I do respond to every single comment, so if you have any other questions or video ideas, make sure to leave them down below. I do have a playlist of everything you need to know about college, so if you want to go check it out, it'll be right here. And if you want to join the family of over 1,000 subscribers now, you can click right here. And yeah, that's it for me this week, guys, and I will see you guys next week.